All right, guys, let me start this watch list video by saying that, you know, I've been running scans every night looking for something to trade the next day intraday for, I don't know, 15, 20 years. And the market's weird right now. You see the SPY breaking out. These are daily candles on the SPY. Actually had a nice move today, breaking out to all-time highs. But the weird thing is when I run my scans at night, you know, one of my scans, obviously just a very simple one, looking for high relative volume and a decent percentage move, right? It's as simple as that. And there's not many stocks that are standing out, right? It's like the overall market is moving, but on an individual basis, there's not a lot of great moves. It's just kind of, it's a little weird out there. It's not me complaining. I'm just kind of telling you what I'm seeing. It's just a little weird. How to handle it, I'm not sure. I tweeted today that last Wednesday was my first red day of 2021. And then Thursday, red again. Not by much, basically kind of a flat day, but still red. And then Friday, the market was closed. And then red again today. So now I've had three red days. I can't even remember the last time I had three red days in a row. And then that's not me blaming the market or anything. It's me blaming the guy at my keyboard. I think I'm over trading. Let me show you the SPY intraday real quick here. You know, it looks like it made a big move, but it's been like, look, from here to here, it's probably almost 5 hours of the day. And it really just kind of just sideways for 5 hours. It's been, there's just not been a lot of great intraday action. I don't know. Anyway, I'm not complaining. I'm just saying I don't have a very good feel for how to trade the market the last few days at all. I'm hoping, you know, there'll be some individual standouts and then I can start trading the way I trade again. But in the meantime, I'm slowing my roll a little bit because I hate losing money. All right. Anyway, what are we watching for? A couple highlights real quick. Great call by Wayne today on BTBT. He called this over 1535, which is when it looked about like them. What a great call. You had a recent high here. The earlier high today, 1535. And if you look back, Thursday's high, 1535. So you had one of those 2-day high breaks and then another catalyst just above at 1543. So it all played out beautifully. Great call by Wayne. And from 1535, it ended up going to 1690. So that was kind of a nice little standout. And Wayne also gave us DMYD over 22, which is right here, second mouse, right? The earlier high was 2250. There's the 22 break. And it went to 2350, I think, before rolling over at the end of the day. So a couple nice calls by Wayne. Anyway, my voice is coming back a little bit, but I still don't want to push it. So I'm going to get into the watch list now and then get out of here, right? CEMI, massive volume, 264 million, closing well off its highs. But I'm going to watch it. I'm a day trader. We'll watch it tomorrow. VVOS, trying to break out of this long 3-month sideways action. Decent volume today for this stock. Topped out at 1010, closing all the way down at 935 though. But I'm going to watch that one. MOGO is just a Bitcoin play, and Bitcoin has been acting pretty well lately, pretty strong. So I'm going to watch that one. That's BTBT that Wayne called today was a Bitcoin play. And there were some laggards, and MOGO was one of them. I actually called MOGO through 10 right here. And I know some folks in chat made money through 10 with the earlier high. So, you know, we like stacked catalysts. The earlier high, 1009, and then Thursday's high, 1009. So you had the whole number break, and then basically a 2-day high break above that, and that played out pretty well too. Excuse me. All right, I got to get to short and sweet now. So we're going to watch MOGO tomorrow. RHE, nice volume, closing well off its highs, but maybe a follow-through day tomorrow. MVIS, another red day, but you got kind of, it looks like maybe two inside days after the big move on the Microsoft news. So I definitely want to keep my eyes on that one. RCON, now hit the 20-day. It goes back on bounce watch. No trades in it today. It was on bounce watch for today, but didn't give any kind of setup. We'll watch it again tomorrow. Chewy, CHWY, after the gap up on earnings, topped out at 92.52 that day. Then the next day lower again. Now it's back down into support. From what I read, earnings looked pretty good. So maybe ready to, now that it's back down to support, maybe ready to turn back up. So we're going to watch that one. EZGO is kind of a sleeper pick. I'm pretty sure this is the golf cart company. And I'm pretty sure it's a low float. I'm actually going to check that as I'm talking. Yeah, 3.3 million, and it is recreational vehicles, China, is what it says on Finbiz. So, but, you know, maybe it's finally did a double bottom from here to here, and it's curling back up. Nice volume for this stock. It's a thin one, so be careful. It's going to have to set up really well for me to trade it. Looking for a follow-through day. NEXT, nice little kind of mini breakout today, although closing off its highs. We're going to watch that for a follow-through day. And a couple more. UAVS, nice curl back up today on decent volume. And SAP had nice news today and a strong close. We'll watch that for a follow-through day, too. That's about all my voice can handle. I'm done. See you guys in the chat room in the morning.